In the next couple of years, flying taxis will begin to appear in the skies of the largest megacities. These are EVTOLs, electric vertical takeoff and landing aircrafts. Dozens of new companies are fighting for the opening trillion-dollar market, developing their unique designs and entire ecosystems. This type of aviation was made possible thanks to the development of battery density. And now, drones can lift not only the camera, but also a couple of people, transporting them for tens of miles. As of the end of 2021, only a few companies have a full-size working aircraft, and are already running demo flights. A dozen more companies will present their aerial vehicles in the next couple of years. And hundreds more startups are still trying to make their first prototype fly. Joby Aviation is currently in the lead, setting the range record for EVTOLs with 155 miles. The path to this achievement took 12 years. Before Joby S4, there were several different designs and innovative ideas, 8 patent applications, like this propeller converting into a wing. But eventually came to this shape. However, there will be those who will write in the comments, "Nothing new, we've already seen all this before."
Boring!
New here is unprecedented flight safety, costs, and noise level. Helicopter has hundreds of vulnerabilities, failure of any of which could lead to disaster. And still, they fly pretty well. EVTOLs can do better. There is zero single point of failure. Distributed propulsion system, independent battery packs, duplicated control systems, wings, and ultimately a ballistic parachute are a guarantee of safety. In the future, the human factor will also be excluded. It is easier to create an autopilot for flying than for driving around the city. There are fewer surprises in the air. Today, the cheapest helicopter flight costs from $150 for 15 minutes. A similar flight on EVTOL will compete in price with a taxi ride. Let's compare Joby with an electric car. Both have capacity for 5 people, similar weight and total power. But Tesla has twice the range with half the battery capacity. So, is an electric car 4 times more efficient than EVTOLs? No. The winged EVTOL consumes less energy per mile than an electric car, especially at high speeds, as flight is more energy efficient due to less friction. But to meet current safety requirements, Joby will always carry around 30 minutes of energy reserves. Dead weight to keep passengers alive. There is also the strongest energy overrun during hovering, which is comparable to the Tesla's ludicrous mode.
Ludicrous speed! Go!
Not just for a few seconds, but for about half a minute during takeoff and landing. With the further development of packaging and energy extraction technologies, electric air transport will become cheaper than traveling in a car. But so far, there is no really mass production of EVTOLs yet. The manufacturing cost of one Joby S4 will be more than $1 million. Joby S4 will not be available for private purchase, and will be used only as an air taxi, with an expected revenue of more than $2 million per year. You can't fly in most areas of the city in a helicopter due to high noise pollution, but Joby is quieter than your vacuum cleaner. Compare this.
And over here behind me is our aircraft in hover. And finally, thank you to all of you in the global community for cheering us on.
Finally, main advantage of all EVTOLs is time savings. Even passenger drones may save more than an hour on distances of up to 20 miles. Or can get you out of dead traffic one day. 5 to 7 seater models are able to save a few hours on a route up to 100 miles. With the increase in flight range, EVTOLs will be able to replace common aviation on mid-distance routes. After all, EVTOLs do not need remote airports, and they are able to provide a transfer from the center of one city to the center of another, which means they can be faster and more convenient. Joby Aviation raised about $800 million in investments, and twice more, after going public. The company has entered into strategic partnerships with NASA, Toyota, Intel, Garmin, and Uber, with plans to build an entire urban air mobility ecosystem. Today, this company, with 1,000 employees, is valued more than $4 billion. It all started when 7 engineers began to explore the existing boundaries of flight technology. And now, they are among those who are revolutionizing transportation, moving our daily trips to the skies. But they are not alone. Chinese company Ehang was founded in 2014. 2 years later, a single passenger drone took off. In 2018, the two-seat Ehang 216 was introduced. The drone is designed for short flights of up to 20 minutes inside the city. Therefore, it has a different design concept, which is better suited for hovering, but less effective during level flight. It weighs only about 360 kilograms, but is capable of lifting 220 kilograms of payload. Cruising speed 100 kilometers per hour, flight range 35 kilometers. Not much, but enough to get from the airport to the city center, or deploy a wide network of aerial taxis. And these guys already know how to scale air transportation, because they have experience in managing a swarm of drones of thousands. But there is a lot of skepticism about the company's success. First, safety. Ehang 216 has no parachute, no wings, all hope for the well-coordinated work of distributed electric propulsion. Secondly, two-blade propellers. Due to their high rotational speed, they make more noise than Joby. And they are located at the bottom of the aircraft. This means that in order to enter, you need to walk through the sharp blades. And you might be thinking, what if? Thirdly, the internal volume of the vehicle. It may not be enough to accommodate two Europeans.
Jack, can you get a bigger car? No way. That's your car? No, dude, no way.
Fourth, a large incline during flight, which can cause discomfort. But given the density of Asian cities, there will hardly be a shortage of people willing to fly. In addition, the company has a cargo version of the 216, and even an option for fighting fires and emergency medical services. Ehang small drones are already working in the delivery of groceries and small parcels. And this is how automated points might look like. Also, there is a new winged EVTOL under development. Oops, not this. This one. The VT-30 will be able to carry 2 passengers over distances of up to 300 kilometers. But again, there is a problem with how the passengers will get inside. May need a little help. Nevertheless, the company has only 250 employees and received $130 million investments. And it has already established small-scale production of autonomous air taxis. And you can buy yourself a batch of these for about $330,000 apiece. At the end of 2021, the public company Ehang is worth less than $1 billion, which seems to be an undervalued asset. After all, if this team has achieved such outstanding results in just 7 years, then what can we expect from them in the future? Lilium Jet is definitely the most beautiful. It is a kind of luxury among EVTOLs, but it comes with a price. The cost of producing one jet is about $2.5 million. It is expected that one jet will generate $5 million in revenue per year. The German team started development in 2015 with seed funding from the European Space Agency and Climate Kick program. A series of prototypes resulted in a 5-seater model. But the first to enter the market, in 2024, will be a 7-seat jet with the following specifications. Flight range 250 km, including reserve. Cruise speed 280 km per hour. 36 ducted fans, with a total power of more than 1 megawatt. And less than 10% is required while cruising. Maximum takeoff weight is 3,175 kilograms. The company plans to both sell jets and establish its own service, which is focused on intercity flights. The price of one Lilium Jet will be $4.5 million. The cost of the flight promises to be comparable to the usual aviation. Lilium's design differs from others in scalability. Company plans to build a 16-seat aircraft in 2027 and a 50-seater by 2030. Lilium has over 700 employees, raised $380 million. And, like Joby, the company went public in September 2021 and at the end of the year is valued at $2 billion. The German Volocopter team began development in 2010. A year later, they were already flying a demo model. In 2016, a full-size prototype made its first manned flight. Volocopter Volocity has similar specifications to Ehang, but it is more comfortable and safer. Therefore, it has slightly less payload. Moreover, the first commercial flights in 2023 will be carried out with the help of a pilot, which leaves only one seat for a passenger. The company also has a drone, adapted for cargo delivery, Volodrone. And is preparing a 4-seat Voloconnect for medium range flights. An autopilot and an ecosystem are under development. This is the company's vision of what the future takeoff and landing points might look like. Due to the lack of space, Voloports will have to be built on the roofs of existing buildings. And this is not always possible, due to the excessive load on the electrical network. But German engineers envisioned the ability to quickly swap Volocity's batteries. Which means that the Voloport will be able to satisfy a large proportion of its energy needs at night. The private company Volocopter has more than 450 employees, has received $370 million investments, but so far cancelled the listing. Vertical Aerospace is a British company founded in 2016. At the end of 2021, it has a full-scale prototype, testing and design finalizing of which will take the next 2 years. The company managed to build and test two prototypes. The final design has 8 propellers, 4 of which are inactive during cruising and create unnecessary drag. Aircraft can hold 4 passengers and 1 pilot. The maximum flight range is over 100 miles. Top speed is 200 miles per hour. Certification is planned for 2024. The company employs over 250 people. Raised $300 million in investments. Strong partners and pre-orders for more than 1,000 of aircrafts are on board. VAX4 has an estimated manufacturing cost of $1.7 million. In December 2021, the Vertical Aerospace went public. The youngest company on our list, Ucha Aviation, was founded in 2018. The 5-seat maker has a very similar design to the Vertical X4, but is rated for shorter flights, up to 60 miles. Ucha Aviation has about 200 employees, and has raised more than $900 million, including money from going public. Market capitalization is $1.6 billion. The company's ambitious plans are to begin the first commercial flights in 2024. But so far, there is not a single video they have anything flying. 2-seat, 80% scale model was built to demonstrate and test technologies. The estimated manufacturing cost of the production model is $1.2 million. Let's take another look at 6 innovative companies that will reshape the skylines of our cities over the next decade. Who do you think will be the most successful? Who will be the first to double their market cap? There are several hundred more companies without a lot of money, but with intriguing concepts. And unlike cars, where everything is roughly similar in design, there is still a lot of variety in the emerging industry of electric aviation. And no one knows yet which design will be the most suitable for the daily transportation tasks. There are already a dozen working models of personal electric aviation. Consider a subscription if you don't want to miss the second part. The robot Brian was with you. Bye.